friend, a family member, co-worker, whatever. And you might think that my address today is really for those who are becoming new citizens. But in truth, I think it's for all of us. And I want you all to just pay close attention, because I'm going to remind you all how lucky we are to be citizens of this great nation. Now, I want to begin today's ceremony by acknowledging and holding this ceremony on Treaty 1 land on the traditional territory of the Anishinaabe, and also the homeland of the Métis people. You know, each June, Canadians celebrate the National Aboriginal History Month, which is an opportunity to honor the heritage and the cultures of the First Nations, Inuit, and Métis communities right across Canada. You know, the history of Canada's Indigenous people, it's rich, and it is very, very diverse. Much more diverse than you might realize. Their history goes back thousands of years. Thousands of years. In fact, they say that the First Nations people were meeting at the Forks, which is really right behind where we are right now, for over 6,000 years. So the history of the Indigenous people goes back a long way, long, long before the Europeans arrived on the eastern shore of what would later become known, of course, as Canada. The history of the First Nations, the Inuit, and the Métis people, in essence, is really the history of Canada itself. It's true. They were the first peoples of Canada and continue to play important roles in Canada's development and also in its future. Now, although Indigenous peoples have many similarities, there's also many, many differences. It's very diverse. There's many different distinct aspects of heritage, language, culture, and also spiritual beliefs. Together, they speak more than 50 different languages. And many of those are spoken in Canada. Just recently, Canada appointed its first Indigenous citizenship judge, Suzanne Carrier. She is an amazing lady, and I'm delighted to say, I'm proud to say, that she's with us this afternoon. In fact, she's sitting right over here. So, can you stand for a moment, please? It's essential we acknowledge the country's past as we move towards a new nation to nation relationship based on rights, respect, and partnership. All Canadians are now moving forward on the road to reconciliation, and it's giving all of us the opportunity to leave a proper legacy for future generations. Now, we can do that, ladies and gentlemen. We can do that. And the truth is, we must. We must do that. You know, let's face it, I'm a stranger to the First Nations. We are all immigrants. We are. We are all immigrants. Now, we don't all share the same past. That's pretty much a given. But we all share the same future. And that future, ladies and gentlemen, is Canada. We're just 2 days away from a very special day, and there are a few more days away from other special days that we're going to tell you about. Of course, on Thursday, that's just the day after tomorrow, it's the first day of summer, summer solstice, the longest day of the year, actually. And it's also National Indigenous Peoples Day, and it's a celebration of Indigenous peoples' culture and heritage. That date was chosen because it corresponds to the, as I mentioned, the summer solstice. And it's on that day, around that time of year, that Indigenous people groups gather to celebrate their culture and their heritage. Now this day, the National Indigenous Peoples Day, is a wonderful opportunity to become better acquainted with the cultural diversity of First Nations, the Inuit, and the Métis peoples. They have many distinct accomplishments that they've contributed to us over the years, and it varies from agriculture to the environment, all the way to arts and culture. And then, of course, that very special day is on Thursday, June the 21st. Now coming up this Sunday is St. Jean Baptiste Day, a very special day for the Franco Canadian community, as they recognize a very special day. In fact, it's a holiday in the province of Quebec. That's on this Sunday. The following Sunday, that's the big one, Canada Day. That is the big one. And for many of you, it's going to be the first time you're going to celebrate Canada Day as a Canadian. So it's going to be very special to a lot of you here in the room today. We have some very special guests. I just introduced one of them a few moments ago. We also have some with us from the Canadian Armed Forces. We're going to be bringing greetings a little bit later on. I'm always delighted to have somebody from the Canadian Armed Forces in attendance. And today we're delighted to have this, Captain Wright Arubik. Thank you for being here, sir. Thank you. Don't put those clappers away. We also have some very special volunteers here. They're here every ceremony. They help you find a seat to the room. I don't know if we can do absolutely thrilled and delighted to have him with us here every day. The wonderful ladies are dressed in red, they're just over here, DWight, Ingrid Price, and Phil Hunter. Thank you very much, ladies. Now, I also want to start off by just sharing a recent quote from our Prime Minister, Justin Trudeau, because it's very relevant to why we're all here today. The Prime Minister said, "We've created a society where individual rights and freedoms, where compassion and diversity are core to our citizenship. But underlying that idea of Canada is a promise. It's a promise that we all have a chance to build a better life for ourselves and also for our children." You know, for those of you becoming new citizens today, Tuesday, June the 19th, this is a day you're going to remember for a long time. In fact, I dare say, you're going to remember this day for the rest of your lives. Not only will you remember it, but you're going to remember it very, very clearly. Because I hear this from people who've gone through this ceremony many, many years ago, 10, 20, 30, 40 years ago, and tell me they remember the day they became a Canadian, just like it was yesterday. It leaves that much of an imprint in their memory. Now, why is that? Why does it leave such an impression on your memory? Well, for one thing, for many of you, it's a dream that you've held for many years, and that's to become a Canadian. Maybe that's the most important aspect of all. Each one of you here today, every single one of you is about to become a Canadian. Each one of you has your own story and your own reasons as to how and why you selected Canada. For some of you, not all, but for some of you, the road to get here is not easy, and we know that. But regardless of where you're from, and regardless of whatever path you've had to take to get here, the good news, the really good news, is that you are here. You're here, you made it, and you're about to become a Canadian. You know, as you look at what's happening elsewhere in the world, and you can do that very quickly, 24/7, any time of the day or night, turn on the television news, it's going 24/7, listen to the radio, turn on the internet. But when you see what's happening elsewhere in the world, you quickly realize just how fortunate we are, to live in this country, to be Canadians. But it also gives us the opportunity to think very clearly and remind ourselves that we need to celebrate. We need to celebrate our shared values. We need to celebrate our achievements as a nation. Let me tell you, we have a lot of achievements as a nation. But maybe most importantly, it's a time to celebrate our place in the world. Because ladies and gentlemen, Canada does have a very, very important place in the world today. And its stature seems to be growing with each passing month and year. Over the past several decades, Canada has become a very multicultural, a very multinational country. In fact, today, there are over 100 different languages spoken in every major city, every day in this country. And that includes the city of Winnipeg. Throughout our history, millions of immigrants have helped to build this country, our country. And Canada welcomes people from more than 100 different countries each and every year. You know, it's thanks to Canada's amazing diversity, not in spite of it, but because of it, that we have become a role model for the world. I just emphasize that point. Nearly a quarter century ago, 23 years ago in fact, former United States President Bill Clinton visited Canada, and he gave it an address in the House of Commons to all the members of Parliament. In that address he said, "In a world darkened by ethnic conflicts that often tear nations apart, Canada stands as a role model for the world, of how people of different cultures can live and work together in peace, prosperity, and in mutual respect." But you know, the United Nations has been saying for many years, many, many years, that Canada is one of the most desirable places in the world to live. Did you know that? I know you do. That's why you're here this afternoon in this room, I'm sure of it. And in a few moments, this country is going to become an even better place to live. You know why? Because we're going to welcome some very outstanding citizens into the Canadian family. And that's all of you that are becoming citizens here this afternoon. As you know, becoming a Canadian, it's not easy. To arrive at where you are today, you've demonstrated courage and perseverance. You've had to work hard. You've had to study hard. You've had to adjust to a new culture. You've had to adjust to a new way of doing things. You've had to make new friends, Some of you have to learn a new language. And every single one of you, every one of us, have to make a new home in an unfamiliar country. An accomplishment like this, it's never easy. It's never easy. And it's certainly not without its challenges. But as those of you becoming new citizens of Canada today already know, becoming a Canadian is more. It's actually a lot more than a list of things you're allowed to do. Becoming a Canadian is in fact a covenant between you and this nation. In other words, it's a bond. It's a bond that will go with you, and it will be with you from this day forward. And it's going to be with you for the rest of your life. One of the key benchmarks of Canada, and I think one of the real benchmarks of being a Canadian, is the word freedom. You know, it's hard to outline what freedom is and what it means to everyone, because truthfully, if we went around the room right now, we'd probably find that freedom means something a little bit different to each and every one of us that's gathered here today. But as you embrace and celebrate the new freedom you're about to receive as Canadians, I want you to always remember, and please never forget this, the freedom we have, the freedom you're about to receive as a Canadian, was not free at all. This nation, Canada, paid a very heavy cost with two world wars, and the Korean War, and the many subsequent conflicts, up to and including the current war that's now going on today in the nation of Afghanistan.